Let's look at how to make this logo. A convenient way to do this is to use the power stroke. It wasn't until Illustrator CS6 that you were able to create a variable stroke width. It's a powerful tool to have in your arsenal. So let's have a look. I select the ellipse tool and drag a circle. I will make the start and end points fit the large arc. I go to Path Effects and choose Power Stroke. I want the start and end cap to be rounded. I drag the purple control point to adjust the width. I lower the opacity so I can clearly see both shapes. I zoom in on the start point. I fine-tune the endpoint. At this moment I have 3 points to adjust the line width. But you can remove and add points. To add a control point, I control-click on a purple diamond. Now I have 4 points to control the line width. I will create a 5th control point by control clicking on a purple diamond. To make the top curve, I duplicate the large arc. I will reposition the start and end points. I see I must rotate the arc somewhat. So I press the spacebar. I will have to rotate a bit more. But this time, I will reposition the rotation point. I'll save my paths, so I can adjust them later if needed. So I duplicate them. I hide the original shapes that have the live path effects. Then I will turn the duplicates into regular paths and unite them. Now let's color the path. I go to fill and stroke and select radial gradient. I select the gradient tool and move the gradient to the bottom left. I click on the dropper tool and sample the green. And for the outside color, I sample the blue. I shift control drag to make the gradient bigger. Now let's place the text. I will use Assistant, which is a free Google font. I click on spacing and set spacing between letter to 15. I want to remove the horizontal stroke from the letter A. To do this, I go to Path, Object to Path. I select the Node tool and drag over the horizontal stroke. I press Delete.